this is the state of my desk after glazing for a while
of it, and then I colored it in. I woke up really early this morning for some reason. I woke up at 6 a.m. I stayed in bed watching TikToks for like an hour. I tried to go back to bed and then I was like, this is stupid. I'm so tired today if I go back to bed. So I got up at 7, I washed my face, and here we are.
You about owning your own shop or opening a small business is the sheer amount of cardboard boxes and packaging and trash that you end up with. It's just part of like ordering supplies. You get them in these huge boxes and it takes up a lot of space. But yeah, I mean, my tactic is just to fold them up and store them in my closet that's filled with cardboard boxes in case I want to reuse them. But it's getting kind of cramped in there, I'm not gonna lie. If anyone was wondering, this is the clay that I use. I only use white Craftsmart clay and I buy it in these big 1 pound blocks. I love the texture of Craftsmart clay. It's not too soft, which you would think that you would want it to be softer, but actually, when Palmer clay is super soft, it's so much harder to work with because it's oily and it attracts more dirt when it's softer and more oily like that. So it's midnight now. This is a whole day's work. I started at 1 and I took breaks and ate lunch and dinner and stuff, so I probably worked around 7 to 8 hours total on these guys. I'm a little upset with myself because I miscounted and I made an extra cake than I needed to, but that's okay. We can save that for another person. But yeah, I love looking at them when they're like this, all lined up. I'm not gonna bake them tonight. I'm gonna wait tomorrow when it's sunny and I can see clearer so I can clean them up a bit more before I put them in the oven. But before I go to bed, I need to clean all of this up. But yeah, I'm gonna clean up, I'm gonna journal a bit, and then I'm gonna wash my face and I'm probably gonna knock out. I'm really exhausted, but Yeah, I didn't film a lot of the sculpting. I only did the first half of it, really. The other half is actually putting on the toppings and adding the metal fixtures. So yeah, I'm sorry I didn't film that. I'm gonna get better at filming and vlogging in general, I promise. But yeah, today I just sculpted. I watched like 5 hours worth of Emma Chamberlain videos and I'm really tired. So I'll see you guys tomorrow or whenever I decide to vlog next. So this is the state of my desk after glazing for a while. I use this like cork board to kind of protect my table, even though I've already destroyed it. I'm just trying not to get any more glaze or paint stains onto my table. But I wanted to show you guys the radies. And so for the desk fronts, I like to tape them onto something like a paint bottle or a box or like an empty jar, like something with a lid. It's way easier to glaze them without getting my fingers dirty. And then for the baby radishes, I got this shelf from IKEA and I got it specifically for this reason, so I could hang the radishes while they were drying, which I love so much. I can hang so many at a time. I used to only have these two jars and a paintbrush and I could only hang like 10 at a time, so it really slowed me down. I am upgrading, you guys. I am scaling my shop and it starts with a $13 IKEA shelf. And I just finished glazing everything. I also made the keychains, so I used the jump rings and attached all the metal fixtures. Here's a little daisy frog cake. I got a couple of cake orders. I got a lot of wizards this time. I think it's because autumn is coming up. So it's kind of like my only Halloween themed radish so far. But yeah, and I wanted to show you guys this custom bear. So a customer actually reached out to me about making a custom bear for his girlfriend. So I'm really excited for them to get this in the mail. And yeah, so the last thing I have to do is add these to the keychain cards, put these into their cardboard boxes, and then I'm ready to ship. My boyfriend's actually gonna come over to help me with all this so we can make it before the post office closes today. Yeah. 광진대교 건너면서 든 생각 없어 맘에 드는 사람 넌 난 많이 컸어 그냥 뒀어 외로운 그 맘은 불 붙여 지활화탄에 붉고 서서히 태가네 다리 밑 주저앉아 순식간에 지나가 시간 그냥 what's up 후회할 순 없어 어지러워 외청 외청 여러 마음들 흩어져 난 돌아가면서 기억이 하나 두 개 없어져 그래도 남아있을 걸 너가 말든 Hi! It's been a couple days since I last spoke to you guys. the past couple days I've just been getting ready for school. I'm taking a painting course this year and it's working with three mediums: oil, acrylic, and gouache. So the supply list was pretty extensive. I'll show you guys what I got. I got this whole tote bag worth of stuff and more. I'm starting school in less than a week now, which is really scary to me. I don't know how I'm gonna time manage my stuff. So a lot of my work recently has been preparing my shop stuff for when I'm back to school and I won't have as much time to do it myself. But first, let's look at my art supplies because I really like getting art supplies. I got a whole pack of new paint brushes. These are all synthetic and she specified that she wanted synthetic bristles that were quite firm, so I had to get a new set because I didn't have that. Then I got these gesso brushes, and then my boyfriend and I went to the thrift store and got a ton of old picture frames. I'm gonna use this for myself. I think this would be really cute to have a little painting in there or something. But the rest of these, I'm gonna take them out of the frame and use the glass to create my own glass paint palette. It's the cheapest way to do that and it's super easy. There's always picture frames at the thrift store. So all you have to do is take it out of the frame and then tape the edges so you don't get cut by them, and then you can use it as a palette. So that was really nice. I already had a whole Hini jelly gouache set, so I was set on that, but I didn't have any acrylic or oil paint, so I had to get all of those. I put them all in this container already. And then I got a little palette knife, which I'm really excited about. For fun, I got this. I saw this at the art store. It's called the Master's Soap, and apparently it's a specially formulated soap that makes cleaning up safe and easy using only water. It keeps hands soft and fresh smelling, so I love that.
Another thing I've been doing this week is making new thank you cards, where they're the size of a postcard and the front is a design so customers can use it as a little art print after they see the message on the back. And so the process of doing that was, I first sketched out a design in Procreate, and this is basically the sketch of it, and then I colored it in and added a grid in the background, and I think it's really cute. Yeah, and this is the full design of the front, and then the back is this. And this is actually what I used to give my customers. It was a little printout that said, "Thank you, blank, for supporting Uncomfy Studio. Wishing you all the serotonin, the Uncomfy team." I wanted to make the message feel a bit more sincere, and I switched it from the Uncomfy team to just Uncomfy because I didn't want people to think that there's like a whole team behind this. That's my dream eventually. I want a whole studio. That's why it's called that. But right now it's just me and my boyfriend who helps occasionally. And I saw a lot of other artists do it to where they have a postcard and they have a space where they use tape to tape down a free sticker. So basically, it'll look like this, to where it's like a postcard in the back and a little sticker will be there for them to grab. So yeah, I'm really excited for that. And I ordered 500 of them, which is a lot, but beforehand I would print out my own print, and my printer can't do front and back, so it'd be blank on the back, and then I print out this separately, and then I get the sticker separately. So because school is starting, I really want to save time for myself, and even though this is like a scary process for me to hand over the printing work to some other person and to pay a lot of money up front, I think this will save me a ton of time in the long run, and I'm really excited for them to come in. They're gonna come in this weekend, so it'll probably be in my next vlog where I open that package.
So yeah, this is just what I've been working on this week. Of course I've been sculpting and packing orders, as you know, but this is just something that I've been really putting off, and I'm so happy I finally got started on giving my work to someone else, if that makes sense. These are the baby steps I'm taking to help my business be more efficient. So yeah, that's it for this vlog. Thank you so much for joining me this week, and I'll see you next time.